Hi everybody, welcome to our next Sun and Earth lesson. We have done rotation of the Earth, shape of the Earth, and talked about the Earth's axis, that it tilts on its axis. Remember, here is a model of our Earth. It's not straight up and down like this, it's actually tilted this way, all right? So we're gonna take a look at the position of the Earth around the Sun, as well as a couple other things that come into play with this tilt of the Earth's axis. So let's go ahead and get started. So here we are in position one. So we're going to call position one. And we are right up here in North America, the orange continent, remember that? And we know that the Earth is always spinning. It's always rotating, and it's always revolving around the Sun. Well, when the Earth is right here in this position one with the Sun, see where how the Earth is tilted this way? We have equal days and equal nights. And this is our springtime. You think about in springtime, how you have equal days and equal nights? Well, we know the Sun doesn't stop revolving. And as it continues to go around the Sun, the days are getting longer and the nights are getting shorter, longer days and shorter nights until we're right here. And this is where we have our longest day and our shortest night. And this is the beginning of our summer. And as you can see, here we are in North America, we're tilted towards the Sun right now, aren't we? You see that? We're tilted towards the Sun. But the Earth doesn't ever stop rotating and it doesn't ever stop revolving. So it's gonna continue to come this way. And the nights are gonna get a little bit longer and the days a little bit shorter until it gets right here. And you can't see the Sun right now, it's kind of blocking it, isn't it? Right here, we have equal days and equal nights again. So we did spring, summer, fall. So this is our fall season. And the Earth continues to revolve around the Sun and our nights get a little bit longer and our days get a little bit shorter. Nights a little longer, days a little shorter until we're right here where we have our longest night and our shortest day of the whole year. And you notice we're tilted away from the Sun. So this is our winter right here. We have our shortest day and our longest night, but the Earth continues to revolve and the days get longer and the nights get shorter. Days continue to get longer, the nights a little bit shorter, until we're back here in position one, where we have equal days and equal nights. Okay, cool. So let's take a look at this chart. So here we have a chart showing something similar, okay? So here in position one, you can see the tilt of the Earth's axis is the same direction we were just talking about. Here is when we had days that were equal length, we had equal night and equal daytime. And as we continued to travel around the Sun, our days got longer and our nights got shorter. And our days got longer and our nights got shorter until we got right here, position two. Now you see the tilt of the Earth's axis? We are right here, we are tilted towards the Sun. This is our summertime, okay? And the Earth kept going around the Sun. And our days got shorter and our nights got longer. Days got shorter still, nights a little bit longer until we got to here, where we had equal days and equal nights again. This is autumn or fall. Then the Earth kept going because it'll always keep going. And the days got a little bit shorter and the nights a little bit longer. Days shorter still and the nights longer still until we got to here. And this is our winter. And we're up here, right? We can see that we are actually tilted away from the Sun. And again, the Earth kept going around the Sun and we got longer days and shorter nights until they became the same length. Now we have two places that the days and nights are the same length, don't we? We have it in the spring and the fall. Well, we have a special name for these. We call them the spring equinox and the fall or autumn equinox. And you hear that word equi, sounds like equal. Well, that's because we have equal length of day and night right here. Okay, and then as we continued on, our days got longer and our nights got shorter until we had our longest day and our shortest night. And we were tilted towards the sun here, well, this is our summertime. And we call this summer solstice. We have another time, and we go here, we have equal days, equal nights, and then we come here where we have our shortest day and our longest night. This is called winter solstice. And so remember, solstice comes from two words, sol meaning sun and sistre meaning stand. So it's kind of like the sun stands and then it turns back around. So summer solstice and winter solstice are when the sun stood still in the sky. Do you remember our story from Tilt to the Axis? It stood still in the sky and then it turned around. We have our longest, it stood still. This is our longest in winter, longest night and shortest day. And then it turned around and started traveling back across the sky, where the days got longer and the nights got shorter until we got to our spring equinox. And again, equinox meaning equal day and night, our spring equinox. And then it kept going where we got longer days and shorter nights until we got here, our summer solstice, where the sun stopped and then turned back around and started going back the other way, where we started getting shorter days and longer nights until it was equal here. Okay, so we have two equinoxes, our spring equinox and our autumn equinox, and then we have our summer solstice and our winter solstice. Okay, excellent. I have one more thing I want to show you that relates to the tilt of the Earth's axis. So what I want you to do is I want you to take a look at our North Pole right now, okay? It's spinning, and do you ever see that North Pole really go out of the light? Not really, because I mean, if you look, even looking up here, it's still pretty light up there, isn't it? What about down here at our South Pole? Is it ever really getting light? No, it's really tilted away from the sun right now, isn't it? The North Pole is tilted towards the sun. The South Pole is tilted away from the sun. And this is our summertime, okay? This is when we in North America are in our summertime. Now, when we look over here, tilts the same way. Let's take a look. Look at the North Pole. Is it getting any light now? No, it's not. What about the South Pole? Is it getting light? Yeah, light the whole time, right? Any darkness? Mm-mm. It isn't. This is when we are in our winter solstice. This is position where we're in our winter solstice. So these have a name. The point here where the rays of the sun, the perpendicular rays of the sun, really don't hit the North Pole, and they only hit the South Pole at this time, where when we're over here, it's only hitting the North Pole and it's not hitting the South Pole. These are called the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle. Okay, Antarctica. Yeah, so the Arctic Circle and the Antarctic Circle. And there is a time every year that the Arctic Circle gets all day and no night. It's almost kind of like a perpetual sunrise. I hear it's very beautiful. And then the Antarctic Circle just, you know, is at night, is nighttime all the time. And there's a time when the Arctic Circle is at nighttime all the time and the Antarctic Circle is perpetual sunrise and it's always daytime. And that'd be weird, it'd be very hard to sleep, wouldn't it? Well, humans don't really live down in the South Pole, it's just a whole bunch of penguins, huh? And the Arctic Circle, some people live in the Arctic Circle, so they actually do experience that. That's kind of interesting. So you can see how the tilt of the Earth's axis really has an effect, okay? And you remember that us in North America, we're tilted away from the sun in winter, and we're tilted towards the sun in summertime. We are actually closer to the sun in our wintertime than we are in the summertime. Whoa, mind blown, it's true. Right, the revolution around the sun isn't a complete perfect circle at all. Okay, so that's all I have for you today. Just wanted to leave you with that little tidbit. So when we come back next time, we're going to talk more about the tilt. And we have our Arctic Circle and our Antarctic Circle. We're going to talk about the zones that are between those two places on our Earth. Okay? All right, sugar plums, we're all done for the day. So go ahead and practice this if you want. You can look up more on this on the internet if you would like to. Next time, we're also going to go over the exact dates of these times, where the, you know, pretty close to dates of those times. Okay, all right guys, thanks a lot, and I will see you later. Bye.